The Compassion Furniture Bank, and she's here to present about the bed project. Go ahead.
Thank you. Good afternoon, guys. Thank you so very much for having us here today. I'm so grateful and honored to be here to represent Compassion Furniture Bank. What I was hoping to share with you today is just a little bit about Compassion Furniture Bank, who we are, the history of Compassion Furniture Bank, how our clients obtain furniture, who we serve, where the furniture comes from that we do give away, how we're funded and staffed, and then finally about the bed project which we presented to you. So who we are, I know a lot of people in the community still aren't familiar with us, but we are a 501c3 nonprofit organization, and we are located out on 22 and 674. So we're on the edge of the county, right next to Buckeye Station, out in that direction by the new Dollar General. So we're on the Fairfield Pickaway County line. The mission of our furniture bank is to provide essential furniture items to families of both Fairfield and Pickaway counties. We're serving furniture to families who are in need of furniture due to emergency family crisis. This is a photo of our outside of our building. We're happy to say we just recently painted that. It was a green color, if you guys recall, if you've ever driven out that way. It used to be an antique store out there, so it's now gray. And this is kind of several pictures of the inside of our building. We have kind of three sections to the building, but it is very, very full of furniture. There's about 3,000 square feet of furniture. We're happy to say we have a mezzanine area here in the back that we've just added on to recently that houses some of our couches up at the top. We have a forklift that we transport the furniture throughout the building as well as into vehicles and off of our box trucks. Some history of Compassion Furniture Bank. So we got started back in 2018, and how we came about was God laid it on my husband and I's hearts to start a furniture bank, to start a ministry. We had been working with our local church in Lancaster, and we were providing beds through the Bed Brigade, which is also here in Circleville through Vineyard Church. Vineyard Church had taught our church how to do the Bed Brigade, and so at Crossroads in Lancaster, we were providing families with beds, and my husband and I realized that these families needed a lot more than just a bed. We were going into these homes and seeing that they were living without, using lawn chairs and that sort of thing. As you guys know, there's a lot of impoverished people in the area, and it just broke our hearts, and God used that to really talk to us, and here we are. So 3 years later. So our goal, obviously, is to be a ministry more than a business. We want to share God's word with the people and to witness to them and share a little bit of God's blessing with them. So we're always asked, how do the clients get the furniture? So we work with different agencies throughout the county to find individuals who are in need. The client must have a referral, and they must be indigent. They must, obviously qualify, either be on some form of public assistance or be living among the poverty level. We do limit it to a one-time service, so they can't keep coming out annually. They can only come out one time. And we do generally limit it to 5 to 6 items per family based on our inventory. The agencies that we work with here in Pickaway County, we work with PICA quite a bit, the Haven House, Pickaway County Developmental Delays, Board of Developmental Delays, Head Start, Community United Methodist Church, as well as Integrated Services, and as well as the school system. They'll reach out to us, the counselors there at the school system will let us know which children they have that are indigent and living without. So we're proud to say that in 2021, we served 166 families, 80 of those families were from Pickaway County. 86 of those families were from Fairfield County. We served a total of 211 adults, 170 children. And since we've opened in 2018, we've served 725 families. As always, people always want to know, where do we get this furniture that we so generously give away? This furniture comes from just generous people in the community. You'd be amazed at how many beautiful people live in this area that just gladly give away beautiful furniture. We'll pick up from churches, hotels, businesses throughout here in Fairfield and Pickaway County. Big Sandy is a big supporter of ours, as well as Kokona's and Mason's Furniture. They pass out flyers to their customers to let them know about our organization. So we'll go out and pick up furniture from their customers, as well as furniture gets dropped off under our canopy in front of our building.
Wonderful.
Thank you. We are funded strictly by grants and donations. We are strictly volunteer-based. There are no paid salary employees. So in regards to the bed project that we are requesting from your organization, we are hoping to buy 24 twin beds, as well as 18 queen beds. We are asking for $6,500 to go towards the cost of these beds, and Compassion would come up with the remaining approximately $5,500. We would like to purchase beds from a company called Maylof. We've used this company before to purchase beds, and what we get from them is a 8-inch mattress that sits on a platform frame that's pictured here. Here is a photo of some of the shipments that we've received in the past with previous grant money from other organizations. What's great about these beds is they're lightweight, they're easy to transport, they're brand new, very comfortable, and most importantly, affordably priced. They come at a discount from the company. Families like it when they get a new bed. And to be completely honest, we're just not getting enough donations of beds from the community to support the need.
I hate to stop you there, but in time.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so I'll go ahead and open it up.